हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ मोमेंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मेथड ऑफ सब्जेक्ट स्ट्रक्चरल एनालिसिस 2. मायसेल्फ प्रोफेसर आसिफ बेग फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, नागपुर. द एंड मोमेंट ऑफ अ रिडंडेंट फ्रेम्ड स्ट्रक्चर आर डिटरमाइंड बाय वेरियस मेथड्स यूजिंग क्लैपेरॉन्स थ्योरम. That is also we called as three moment theorem, strain energy method, slope deflection method, and many others method. But these methods of analysis require a solution of set of simultaneous equations. Solving equation is a laborious task if the unknown quantities are more than three in numbers. In such situation, the moment distribution method developed by Professor Hardy Cross in 1930, which is very much useful to analyze the frame structure which is having the unknown more than three. This method is essentially balancing the moment at a joint or the junction. It can be described as a method which gives solution by the successive approximation of slope deflection equations. Now, to analyze any redundant frame structure by moment distribution method, we have to go through several steps, which are: very first is the calculation of fixed end moment, then we have to calculate the distribution factor, and these two values of distribution factors and the fixed end moment we require to calculate the distribution moment. Now, the distribution moment is the calculation of moment, or we can say the distribution of moment looking into the stiffness of the member and the unbalanced moment of the members. We will see this analysis in the detail of the given numerical. The numerical is given of the continuous beam having A, B, C, having two span, where the span AB is subjected to the concentrated load, which is situated at the center, having intensity 100 kN. The span of the beam is 5 meter, and the moment of inertia is 2i, where the beam BC is subjected to the uniformly distributed load of 50 kN per meter, having moment of inertia 3i, and the span of the beam is 6 meter. Now, we have to calculate in the analysis part. If you see it in the step wise, the first step is to calculate the fixed end moment. Now, in the calculation of fixed end moment, we have to calculate the fixed end moment. We write it as MF, fixed end moment. So, for fixed end moment, we need to calculate the fixed end moment of AB, fixed end moment BA, fixed end moment BC, and fixed end moment CB. Now, if we have to calculate the fixed moment AB, which is subjected to the central point load of 100 kN. So, the fixed moment for AB span is WL by 8. We have to write this equation with the minus sign, because with the AB span, the rotation is in anti-clockwise direction. So, as the rotation is in anti-clockwise direction, we have to write it as in the minus sign. So the minus, the value of W is 100 into the value of L is 5. Sorry, it is not square. 100 into 5 divided by 8. If you calculate this value, it is minus 62.5 kN meter, as this is moment. So fixed moment BA is plus WL by 8. It is plus 100 into 5 divided by 8. It is plus 62.5 kilonewton meter. Now fixed moment BC, as the span BC is subjected to the UDL, so the fixed moment BC is minus WL square by 12. So the value of W is 50, the value of L is 6 square divided by 12. So the value which we are getting is minus 150 kilonewton meter. Now fixed moment CB is plus WL square by 12, it is plus 50 into 6 square divided by 12 plus 150 kilonewton meter. Now in the step number 1 we have calculated fixed end moment. Fixed end moment AB, BA, BC and CB we got as minus 62.5 plus 62.5 minus 150 kilonewton meter and plus 150 kilonewton meter. Now moving towards the second step, which is to calculate the distribution factor. Now to calculate the distribution factor, we required to calculate or to determine the relative stiffness of the member. Now this relative stiffness of the member is denoted as K. If the far end of any joint is fixed or it is continuous, then relative stiffness K is I by L, where I is the moment of inertia and L is the span of the beam. And if the far end of the joint is hinge or it is simply supported, then the value of K is 3 by 4 I by L. Now to calculate the distribution factor, which is denoted as DF, which is calculated by the relative stiffness of the member divided by sum of the relative stiffness. Now to determine this distribution factor, we need to draw a table. This table consists of various columns. First column is of joint. Second column is of member. Third column is for the calculation or the determination of relative stiffness looking into the far end condition. Next column is for the sum of the relative stiffness. And finally, we have to calculate the distribution factor by looking this equation. Now, if you see the numerical, it is having only one joint, joint B. So we have to write this as joint B. Joint B is having two members, BA and BC. Now BA, B to A, so A is the far end and which is the fixed one. So if the far end is fixed one, then the relative stiffness value is I by L. So we have to write this value as I by L. So in the span BA, the value of I is 2I and the value of L is 5. So the value which we are getting is 0.4I. Now similarly for BC span, B to C. B to C, the C is the far end and it is a simple support. So it is 3 by 4I by L. So 3 by 4, the value of I is 3, I and the value of L is 6. If you calculate this, so this will be equals to 0.3 by 5i. So if you calculate this value 3 by 4 into 3i by 6, so the value which we are getting is 0.375i. Now we have to sum up this relative stiffness of joint B. So the sum of the relative stiffness of joint B is 0.4i plus 0.375i. So it is 0.775i. Now we have to calculate the distribution factor, and it is calculated by the relative stiffness of the member divided by sum of the relative stiffness of the joint. So the relative stiffness of the member BA is 0.4, and the sum of the relative stiffness of joint is 0.775i. And if you calculate this value, we will get the distribution factor, and the distribution factor is 0.52 for BA member. And if we calculate the distribution factor for BC, that is 0.375i divided by 0.775i. So we are getting the distribution factor for BC is 0.48. So here we have to do the one check for this. We have to sum this value of distribution factor for the joint, and this sum must be equals to 1. So after getting the distribution factor in second step and fixed moment in first step, this both value we require to calculate the distribution moment. So for the moment distribution cycle, we have to proceed for the next step, step number 3. Now we have to move for the calculation of moment distribution cycle, and for which we have to draw a table. So table which we have to draw for this method, for this step, we have to look into the numerical. There are three supports. A and C are the supports, and B is the joint. So we have to draw the line according to it. So there is A support, that is a fixed one. Okay. There is another joint, joint B. So this is joint B. And for C, that is simple support, we have to draw the another line. So these are the joint. Okay, now we have to draw a row for the members which is subjected to that joint. So in the another row of this column, we have to write the name of the members. So for A there is one member AB, so we are writing this at AB. So for joint B, there are two members BA and BC. So we are writing this at this point, BA and BC. Another one support is simple support C1. So C having one member CB. So we are writing at this point CB. Now we have to write the distribution factor which we have calculated in step number 2. So the distribution factor AB, we don't calculate this, so make it as nullify. We have calculated the distribution factor for BA and BC only. Okay, so you can see in the table for BA it is 0.52, and for BC it is 0.48, and CB having no distribution factor. Now we have to write the moment, that is fixed end moment. So fixed end moment AB we have calculated, minus 62.5. BA we have calculated, plus 62.5. BC we have calculated, minus 150, and CB is plus 150. Now we have to do the balancing cycle. We have to perform the balancing cycle, and one more cycle, more step in this is to carry over the moment values. Now, before going into the balancing step, we have to make the support C as zero, because the support C is a simple support and it is at the end. So we have to make it zero. As we know, the moment CB is plus 150 to, so we have to make it as zero by adding minus 150 at this point. So here it is, it will become zero, and we have to carry over this value to the near end. This step is called as the carryover. So we have to perform carryover at this point. So we are carry over this value 150, half of the value of this 150. So we are getting it as minus 75. So again, we have to make it the total of this. So it is minus 62.5. It is 62.5. It is 225, and it is zero. So these are the final fixed end moment values of given numerical. We have make it zero. Now we have to calculate the final moment from this moment distribution cycle or moment distribution table. So we have to first balance this. So we will balance that value. So we will balance the moment at joint B. So moment at joint B are BA plus BC. So the value of BA in the calculator, the value of BA is 62.5 and the value of BC is minus 225. So the unbalanced moment which we are getting is minus 162.5. So this minus 162.5 we have to balance according to this distribution factor of members. So 0.52 is the distribution factor for BA. So this unbalanced moment minus 162.5 will be distributed 52% for the BA and 48% for BC. So minus 162.5 multiplied by 0.52. So the unbalanced moment for BA member we are getting is minus 84.5. So for balancing this value, we have to write it in the plus sign opposite to the value which we are getting. Okay, so 84.5 is the value which we are getting for the balancing this moment. Okay, now the unbalanced moment, that is which we have got as minus 162.5. So the 48% of this value which we have to balance for the BC member. So we have to multiply 0.48 with minus 162.5. So the value which we are getting is minus 78. So to balance this, we have to make it plus 78. Now there are several natures of the supports. The support which is having the simple support or the hinge support at the end, this support is having the nature of donate. This donate half of its value to the nearest end, which we have done in the earlier step. Now fixed support is having the another nature, which is having the nature of gaining, which take the 50% of the value of the near support. So the near support of the AB is BA. So the 50% of this BA value will be gain up by the AB member. Okay, so this step is called as carryover. So the 50% of 84.5 will be donated by BA to the AB member. AB member, due to its nature, as it is fixed one, it will take the moment from BA member. The 84.5, half of this value is 42.25. So this is what the carryover step. Now if you see the balancing moment, after balancing moment there is no another step to do. So we will just sum up all these values. We will make the final moment. So if you sum this value, 62.5 plus 84, 84.5 plus 62.5. So the value which we are getting for BA moment is 147. Whatever value which we are getting for this BA, the same magnitude we are getting for, must be getting for the BC with the opposite sign. So we are calculating this minus 225 plus 78. So the value which we are getting is minus 147. And here the moment has been balanced. Has been balanced means the sum of the moment at joint B becomes zero, which justify the equilibrium condition. Now we have to calculate the moment AB. So the moment AB, initially it was minus 62.5 plus 42.5, which we have to add. So it will be become finally minus 20.25 and it is zero. So this is what we got, the final moment for this numerical. Now we have to solve, or we have to draw the final bending moment diagram. So the final bending moment diagram will be like this. This is A, this is B, and this is C. A, B, C. A to B, AB span is having minus 20.25 moment. So we will look towards B from A, and we will rotate in anticlockwise direction as the sign is minus. So it will be above the line 20.25. Now the moment B to A is 147. So 147, it is in plus sign, so it will rotate in the clockwise direction. So here we have to draw this and we have to connect this point 147. Now B to C is minus 147. To B to C, we will look in this direction and we will rotate in anticlockwise direction, so it will collapse at this point. Now C is having the zero moment, so we will join it as like this. So this is the final moment. So this is pure moment diagram. This value is 147. If we have to add the free bending moment diagram in this, so for free bending moment diagram, AB span is subjected to the central point load of 100 kN of span 5 meter. So the free bending moment diagram will be like this, WL by 4. So W is 100, L is 5, so the value becomes 125. So if we draw in the same diagram, so it will be draw like this, 125 kN. Meter, this is we get from this equation WL by 4. Now the another load is, that is DC span subjected to 50 kN per meter UDL. So it is, we have to draw the bending moment, free bending moment diagram like WL square by 8. So it is, it will be drawn like this. So the value is we are getting is 225. So as in the drawing, I draw it very wrong way, because 225 must be larger than this value. Okay, so the parabolic shape will be drawn more than this apex. Okay, so this value which we are getting, so from this we can calculate the net bending moment. This is the net bending moment which we have to calculate from this equation. So this is what we have learned in the analysis of continuous beam of having two span. We have to calculate the fixed end moment, we have to calculate the distribution factor looking into the relative stiffness of the member, then we have to calculate the distribution factor from the equation K, that is the relative stiffness divided by sum of the relative stiffness. We have calculated distribution factor for joint B, for member BA and BC, the sum of this must be equals to 1. Now we have draw a table for this looking into the diagram or the given figure. A, B, C, three lines we have drawn, and accordingly we have write joint, member and distribution factor and fixed end moment. These two values which we have calculated in earlier steps, and in this table we have performed the balancing and carryover steps to make it the section or the joint moment as balanced one. this will be the final moment, and by taking this final moment we have draw the final bending moment diagram. So this is what about the analysis of any given figure by moment distribution method. So next, in the next class we will see the analysis of beam having three span. Till then, thank you.